Want a simple world? Follow the simple world. Since the death of the former president Chavez in 2013, Venezuela's economy has been in trouble because of the lower oil price. Inflation is getting worse day by day, and the currency denomination is getting bigger and bigger. Maduro had to erase 5 zeros directly on the face value of currency last August. At a time when the economy was in tatters, the general election was also furiously wrangling. Coupled with the satire and criticism from the public, Venezuela's domestic and foreign affairs are as chaotic as their economy. The American countries can no longer stand. They want to unite and have this problem solved. In August 2017, an organization called the Lima Group was founded, consisting most of the North and South American countries, such as Canada, Brazil, Argentina, and Mexico, etc., which we often heard in the international news. The main target of Lima Group is to ease the headaches that Venezuela brought to them. Although United States did not join the group, but their support on this is very strong. Once the Lima Group started to work, they brainstormed a lot of ideas on Venezuela's problems, and finally reached an agreement that the best way to change is President Maduro's post. His removal may not solve the economic problems, but things in politics and diplomacy might be a little easier for Venezuela. Maduro definitely refused to leave and said, "It's none of your business." The Lima Group jumped into public life, not because its capability or influence, but Venezuela's young parliamentary president. The parliament president is just like the chairman of the NPC Standing Committee in China. And Guaido is only 36 years old. He rose through the ranks in such a young age. Basically, we can see he is a political genius. Guaido declared himself as the interim president of Venezuela after he became the parliamentary president within days, which triggered the international politics immediately. No wonder people always say the future belongs to the young. There are some commonalities between Guaido's self-proclaimed president and the Lima Group's brainstorming. So the group supported Guaido with high enthusiasm, which means that most American countries recognize Guaido as president. Although the Lima Group is under the banner of helping Venezuela, once it has the high-profile support of the United States, it will be hard to get rid of the pro-American label. Just like a rating agency accepted investment from a manufacturer, which makes people hard to trust its objective independence. In addition to the Lima Group, Guaido also get diplomatic recognition from many EU countries, including Germany and France. The politicians of European countries may doubt this young man's capability, but they have to show their support for him, since Guaido represents freedom and democracy. If they do not show their support timely for the fighter of democracy, they'll be criticized by the opponents or disappoint their people. Among all the supporters, the most powerful is President Trump. Trump owns nearly 60 million followers on Twitter, including politicians all over the world, which makes him a truly powerful online trendsetter. Since the time when Guaido unexpectedly caught the public attention, Trump has stood up for him on Twitter several times. He also praised Guaido when facing the media. Soon, the aid packages from the United States are also dispatched with the recipient of Guaido. The biggest support Trump gave Guaido was sending his beloved Vice President Pence on 25th February. On that day, in Bogota, the capital of Colombia, the Lima Group held a special meeting and Guaido met Pence, who said he came here with the warm care of Trump. Being able to meet the Vice President and be cared by the President of the United States, Guaido approached the peak of his life. While Guaido felt himself like a fish to water, his legitimate President, Maduro, certainly not, because the public support from the President of the United States can create numerous influence. Those uncertain or lost in this game are likely to be misled, and many politicians and soldiers in Venezuela betrayed Maduro. This is a rather scary situation for Maduro. Maybe he had to hit the road the next day, or even get killed on the road. You may wonder why Maduro did not take advantage of the army's loyalty and arrest Guaido, or even have him assassinated. Of course, Maduro cannot do that. Instead of doing so, he probably prayed for Guaido's safety every night. By that time, Guaido has become the public figure across the world, supported by the top developed country and millions of fans at home. Now, either he woke up with a stiff neck, Maduro will be the one taking the blame. If Maduro eliminated him in a hasty decision, the domestic riots and overseas sanctions will leave Maduro in a more dangerous situation. Therefore, political fight has nothing but strategy, in a fixed manner and skills. Impulse takes its toll. At the end of last month, the Director General of Venezuela Audit Bureau made a speech, doubting that Guaido, as President of the National Assembly, has inconsistencies in his personal asset declaration and consumption expenditure, which needs to be audited thoroughly. At that time, the Director General's speech didn't really arise public concern, but he acted up to his promise, because he really sent an audit team, then the result came out within a month. On the March 28th, he publicized that Guaido had traveled abroad up to 91 times without permission, with a cost of more than 1 million Chinese yuan, which is far above his salaries. These are all suspicious money. Also, Venezuela's legislation says clearly that MPs are not allowed to have any income except their salaries. Subsequently, Guaido breached the law and has been banned from running for public office for 15 years. Keeping a politician outside politics is the severest punishment for Venezuelan civil servants. Guaido certainly won't admit and take it. Yet, if he still conducts public campaigns, he will be put into jail by Maduro's government. Actions coming after warnings lessens political risks. So far, what support Guaido are basically recognitions, partially material support. What he really needs is military help. Talking to the military capability, he is doomed to failure. For a variety of reasons, Maduro doesn't seem to have many friends around the globe. However, friend headcount doesn't matter. One or two heart-sharing friends would be enough. One of Maduro's heart-sharing friends is Russian President Putin. Before the audit director publicized his findings on Guaido, Putin sent hundreds of soldiers with equipment to Venezuela. It was said they were to repair a 300 missile system failure caused by blackouts, dropping by for a visit to check Venezuela's power outage. With the great support from Putin, Maduro collected some confidence to face up to the United States, to confront with the Lima Group, and even to bring Guaido down for disturbing the politics. When the outcome of Maduro's investigation on Guaido came out, the United States could not sit still anymore. The United States has been trying to turn Venezuela from anti-America to pro-America for many years, and Guaido is a good chance they have been waiting for so long. No wonder they fully support Guaido to fight against Maduro. After hearing Maduro has banned Guaido in politics in 15 years, Trump certainly wants to protest, so he let his national security advisor Bolton make a statement. On March 30th, Bolton attacked Russia in a terrible voice, saying that Russia must stop sending soldiers to Venezuela, and those arrived soldiers need to leave ASAP. The United States does not expect Russia to act wildly there and will not do nothing. The Kremlin spokeswoman was amused by those words and said that Russia has signed deals with Venezuela as soldiers are there to fulfill the deal. The United States should not give orders like that. By the way, should the United States fulfill your promise to withdraw from Syria ASAP? The Syrian civil war, especially after 2015, has actually turned into a confrontation between the United States and Russia. In 2016, when Obama was to step down and Trump was running for the power, Obama's weakness and hypocrisy, as well as Trump's stingness and indecision, ultimately led to the United States' total failure to Russia in Syria. Russia has not only secured Syria's territory, but also united with Iran and Turkey, taking its sense of presence in the Middle East to a new level. The wheel of history rolls on. The United States and Russia, the old rivals, encountered again in Venezuela. And this time, Russia is unexpectedly dominating the game, as Russia's military presence in Venezuela is officially authorized, but the United States has no such an advantage. From a military point of view, waging a war in Venezuela would put Russia in a decided disadvantage situation, as the cost of detached military operation is very high. While Venezuela is right at the United States doorstep, and it is very convenient to take actions. But the United States dare not to start a war near home, as Latin American countries would feel screened, as well as the American people. Venezuela is not Syria. In a remote place like Syria, a war can last as long as it needs. Refugees will be ended up in Europe anyway, with little impact to the United States. But things are different in Venezuela. So Maduro has Russia as a foreign aid, while America might not be willing to be for Guaido. If they cannot resort to a war, just apply sanctions on Maduro and public opinion support on Guaido, the latter may be not capable of defeating the former. So to defeat Venezuela, Russia must be defeated first. However, Russia is not afraid of American sanctions. Trade between Russia and United States only peaked at $20 billion, with a low value of less than $1 billion. So America's frequently used economic sanctions have little effect on Russia. Russia's main markets are in Asia and Europe, who are getting more reluctant to listen to the Americans these days. Of course, the other thing America is good at is war, but it's not likely to declare war directly to Russia. If there were no such young man called Guaido in the international politics, then Venezuela would maintain its past status, enduring the hard days one by one and have little threats to America. In order to save cost, Russia won't rush to invest heavily too, but the appearance of Guaido changed the situation. Trump wants to use this young man as a shortcut to turn Venezuela into a pro-American country. Saying this, Putin is tightening his belt to protect Maduro, so the weapons and equipment were shipped over. To the United States, Venezuela also become more of a threat than the past. Only if America keeps provoking Russia, NATO can exist in the name of protecting European security for a long time. Its stimulus was NATO's eastward expansion and playing military exercise in full swing with the surrounding countries of Russia. In order to balance the pressure and discomfort, Russia had to deploy Russian military equipment to Venezuela. It's fair to say that as long as NATO exists, Venezuela would be under Russia's protection.
Thanks for watching. Share if you like us. See you next time.